Good afternoon, everyone. I am Rushali Dhanokar, Assistant Professor, IT Department. In my last video, we learned about principles that supports usability, design standards, and design guidelines. Now, in this video, we will learn about the most important topic, that is Snyderman's 8 Golden Rules. So let's see how exactly these golden rules will be work. Next. Following points are covered in this video, which includes why Snyderman's golden rules and Snyderman's 8 golden rules in detail with examples. Next. Golden rules of heuristics. It provides a convenient and brief summary of the key principles of interface design. Any designer following even these simple rules will produce a better system. In human-computer interaction, there are different collections of design rules, includes such as Snyderman's 8 golden rules, Norman's 7 principle, and Nelson's 10 heuristics. So in this video, we will learn about Snyderman's 8 golden rules. And in my next video, we will explain Norman's 7 principle and Nelson's 10 heuristics. Next. So before start the Snyderman's 8 golden rules, the first and most important questions, why we use these rules? So there are some introductory part. Ben Snyderman is an American computer scientist, consolidated some implicit facts about designing and came up with 8 general guidelines. In designer should develop a particular product or design a particular product by using these 8 general guidelines. These guidelines are beneficial for normal designers as well as interface designers. These are beneficially in experimental assessment of identifying better GUI. GUI means graphical user interface. You should make a qualityful or usable graphical user interface of the particular application or the particular product. There are different companies like Apple, Google, Microsoft are among some of the highly successful companies whose well-designed and produce reflect Snyderman's rules. The characteristics derived from Snyderman's golden rules can be recognized in various user interface guidelines produced by corporate giants like the companies mentioned above. So simply, these all 8 golden rules are followed by each and every designer to design a particular software or particular applications. Clear? Next. Now, see here, these are the main 8 Snyderman's golden rules. The first, strive for consistency, cater to universal usability, next, offer informative feedback, next, design dialogue to yield closure, prevent errors, permit easy reversal of action, support internal locus of control, and reduce short-term memory load. So these are the 8 golden rules of Snyderman's, which will be useful for each and every designer to generate quality product or quality design. Clear? So let's see one by one. The first rule is strive for consistency. Next. So what is meant by strive for consistency? We all are familiar with the word consistency. Consistent means constant, right? So consistent sequence of actions should be required in similar situation. There are some identical technology used such as familiar icons, colors, menu, call to action and also user flow while designing a particular situation or sequence of action. For example, see here, we all are familiar with Instagram, right? So double tap means picture like the pictures, right? Scrolling means enable seeing most recent post, we can view the stories. Tap and hold on story, pause it. We can edit the profile, right? So these are the examples, that is consistent features. These features similarly available in other social medias like WhatsApp, Facebook also used these kind of features. Means these are the consistent features or constant features. Users are most familiar with that, right? Again, next example is in Microsoft Word, in Notepad or in Microsoft PowerPoint. There is file, edit, view, these kind of options are available. These are the most common features. Users easily used the particular application, that are the consistent features, right? So this is the concept of strive for consistency. It includes workflow, different functionality, appearances, terminology, which used in similar situation and in sequence of actions, right? So this is the concept of consistency. You should implement it while designing a particular product. Next. The next rule is cater to universal usability. Universal design strives to wide range of human users of different characteristics, right? There are different types of users are present, their age, culture, educational level and disability, etc. So while designing a particular product, you should analyze all those things. There are frequency of use increase and so the users desire to reduce number of interaction and increase the pace of interaction. Another simple way that is always use keyboard shortcuts like abbreviation, function key, hidden commands, macro facility are very helpful to an expert users, right? So design a particular software by using this shortcut key. For example, cut Ctrl X, copy Ctrl C, then paste Ctrl V, right? We all are used this shortcut keys. So always design a particular software by analyzing all those things. So cater to universal usability, this principle includes keyboard shortcuts, hidden power user features and some automation things, right? So you should design this all things while designing a particular product. Clear? Next. Next and third rule is offer informative feedback. The need to keep the users informed what is happening at every stage of the process. This feedback needs to be meaningful, relevant, clear and fit the context. While designing a particular software, you should provide an informative feedback to the user. See in this diagram, this is the example of Instagram, right? The new post, this notification or pop-up notification will be generated, right? So it gives the proper feedback, then there will be a new post will be uploaded. Clear? The next example, drag and drop files to upload. So users know that what exactly done here, right? Next, uploading a file means user know that what is happening, that is 45% will be completed and remaining, right? So this is just informative feedback. User knows that what exactly happening. So this principle includes some relevant features, importance and urgency, compressible and meaningful information and appropriate context, right? So while designing a particular product, you should analyze all those things. Next. The next and fourth rule is design dialogue to yield closure. This means that the sequence of actions need to have beginning, middle and end. Once task is completed, it gives a provide them informative feedback and well-defined option for the next step, right? For example, see here. If you sent a particular message or if you should send a particular email, so there will be a pop-up notification that is your message has been sent, right? So this is the particular informative feedback or communication between the user and the system, right? The next example is, suppose you have to install a particular software. There were some instructions, you should press on next options, right? So it gives a proper informative feedback to the user. Clear? There is a proper communication between user and the system. So this principle includes grouping of action, explicit completion of action and well-defined option for the next step. Right? So this is, you should design a particular software according to this way. Clear? Next. The next rule is prevent errors. One of the most important principle. A good interface should be designed to avoid the errors as much as possible. But when errors do happen, your system needs to make it easy for the user to understand the issue and know how to solve it. For example, see in this diagram, suppose you have to enter a particular details in any online form, okay? Suppose you enter a wrong email address. So it gives a notification or error. Please enter a valid email address, right? So this is one of the most important thing. users know that what exactly happening here. Clear? The next, this content is currently unavailable. This is some particular error message will be displayed. Clear? So users take a particular action while show or while display this error. So simple way to handle the errors includes display clear error notification to the user along with descriptive hints to solve the problem. Right? While entering a password, there will be a hint option. Clear? So these all things are included in prevent errors. This principle includes error preventions, error corrections, automatic detections of errors, clear error notifications, and also there are some hints for solving the problems. So this is your next rule in golden rules. Next. And the next principle is permit easy reversal of action. It's an instant relief to find that undo option after a mistake is made. We all are familiar with this situation. So you should design a particular software or particular application by giving an undo option. So your users will feel less anxious and more likely to explore options if they know there is an easy way to reverse any accident. So reverse is one of the most important features while develop or design a particular software. So these rules includes no interference with workflow, more freedom for the user, and single action undo versus action history. Clear? And these are the some examples. Your message has been sent. This pop-up notification will be generated in Gmail, right? So there is undo option will be provided. Again, undo option will be provided in some Word file or Notepad, right? Again, there are some checkbox and radio buttons will be provided. So users select a particular option as per their opinion or as per their requirements, right? Next. Next rule is support internal locus of control. Experienced operators strongly desire the sense that they are in charge of the system and that the system responds to their action. Design the system to make user the impetus of action rather than the responders. This means that there are particular decisions or particular requirements is taken by the users while use the particular system or the application. See, there are some examples. The particular notification will be generated, cannot quit while updates are in progress, right? So this notification given by the system, users know to follow it, right? But there are some notification. Are you sure you want to quit this process? So it's as per depend on the user, whether it is quit, cancel or force quit, etc. So users has the high priority at that time. There are some smart alerts, add events to calendars. This kind of option will be given while designing a particular application. So these principles include the user commands, the system obeys strongly release on informative feedback, the principle of least surprise, right? So as per the user's command, the particular design or particular system will be worked. Clear? Next. The last golden rule is reduce short-term memory load. We will learn different types of memory, short-term memory, long-term memory in the previous videos, right? So this principle is one of the most principle because by applying this rule, each and every person, like whether it is technical and non-technical person, use the particular application. The limitations of human information processing in short-term memory requires that display be kept simple, multiple page display, sufficient training time allotted for the codes, mnemonics and sequence of action. See in this diagram, this is the just screenshot of a particular application. There are different stories will be applicable, right? So recently viewed, this option will be given. So user doesn't recall anything. User simply recognize each and every information, right? See in this example, easier to remember is chunk into smaller sets. This number is very hard to remember, right? But suppose this number will be converted into the chunks or groups format. So it's very easy to remember, right? So our attention span is limited and anything we can do make our users' job easier and users' job better. So it's simple for us to recognize information rather than recall it. Means users easily use a particular application. There are some social applications like WhatsApp, Instagram. There are some payment applications like Google Pay, Phone Pay. There are particular options will be given. So user use those applications and move to next step. Each and everything mentioned clearly, right? So this is reduce the short-term memory load. These rules includes Windows dialogs, apps in entirely, recognition over recall, right? Next. The Snyderman's 8 golden rules. While designing a particular application, particular software, you must follow it. Okay? Keep practicing. Thank you.